bank insiders are warning. Thank you, banks. What's the banks doing now? They're warning you guys that American companies will crumble. And it looks like from the charts, it's starting with Airbnb. I will actually go over into the charts, and we have another thing, 34% right here. It says student loan, hey, students, you got to pay your debt, that thing back that you took out. 34% said they're not doing it. Nope, not going to happen. And credit card debt reaches again all-time highs, and the younger generation is like, oh, we're not... We can't do it. We can't make it. What is this interest rate? They never told us about this in school. What is this? So if I make a payment, it still doesn't even pay anything down? Tried to explain that to my high school kids. They could not figure it out. They're like, why does anyone have these? I know, right? Unless this one. Look at this one. That's a Getty image. That's your, if you type in credit card debt, that is what you are going to get shown. She looks like she's kind of happy about it. Oh my gosh, I spent so much on my husband's card. He's really going to have to work. Here we go with the lead story and the stock market that just doesn't know what to do. The Federal Reserve, we'll get into that. The Federal Reserve thinks, okay. All right, Jerome, thinks catastrophe. That's not good when you have Jerome. says this is all going to burn down. My apologies for that. I kind of let it go a little too far. Is coming for U.S. businesses. Think about this. The Federal Reserve is saying catastrophe. That's lots of fire. Destroy business. This guy right here. Oopsies. That darn inflation thing, right? $10 trillion. Little tough to get rid of. But we have insiders, or they call them researchers, at the U.S. Central Bank. Just published a paper. We'll just put that paper aside, that a historic surge in the percentage of distressed American companies could worsen? Yeah, okay. And quote, the share of non-financial firms in financial distress has reached a level that is higher than during most previous tightening episodes. And guys, we haven't seen this tight since never. And they say, well, since 1970, but you have not felt the full effect of the force. Which is like you chop a chicken's head off, and at first you're like, oh, looks like it's running around just fine. And then, oh, that didn't end too well. Believe it or not, I lost a bet on that chicken one. Someone said, yeah, there's been a chicken with no head for over a year. Just ran around, pretended like it was still good to go. Trying to peck seed, hanging out with his buddies. And that's currently our economy. That's what is going on. We're like, oh, I guess it's fine. But anyways, you can Google that chicken lived for over a year. They put water drops in its head and it was fine. One day, I guess the guy forgot to water his chicken and it died. But anywho, the full extent of the damage remains to be seen. Well, now you haven't seen nothing yet. But as for now, the central bank authors say that 37% of companies are in trouble. So think about that. Let's round up. Four. Let's round up. That's almost half, right? 50%. That's what a doom and gloomer will do. It'd take 37 and let's just go out. It's all of it. More than a third of companies could default in the coming months, thanks to tightening the Yahoo. And Jerome, like a hooker, went from fully loose, just hey, to extremely tight. He can't even get anything in there, which I'm a fan of number two. You see, I think we should be more tighter and more responsible. Just a responsible government. Not a loosey-goosey big-time spender. Come on, pull a Dave Ramsey on us. But with all of this tightening comes collapse. Again, but it just takes time. But then we'll look at the charts. And charts don't always correlate with news. So we'll get to that. The Airbnb collapse is real. And I've owned Airbnb. I know how it is. And it's worked. So don't think like, oh, if I just, listen to Robert Kiyosaki, I bet lots of rentals. And then there's like no work. It is a lot of work. Passive income could sometimes be more less passive than what is quoted. Rental revenue has halved in some parts of the U.S., says this chart. Now, what do we do? Well, let's see that chart, Nick. The Airbnb collapse is real. Look at this. Look at revenue. See, that's what you want. When you sell things, sales are great, but it's like, what do I get to keep? Revenue, Phoenix, Arizona, almost. Look at this. Tennessee, half. Phoenix, half. Hey, I know that place. Austin, half. Actually, looking at all this, it looks like every single state is in there. All of them. That's really bad. That's really bad. And not just that. I mean, imagine if you own a property. That is a lot of cash that you have to come up with. I know this. See, for me, I would rather just click a button. If that light bulb ever goes off, it's going to go off really big and really bright. It did for me when I was hanging out with my buddy Steven Van Meter. And he's like, why are you buying all this real estate? You could just click a button. If you think about it, if I'm like, okay, here's 100,000 here, 100,000 here, cash, like gone, poof. And it's very difficult to sell. And it's very difficult to get clients calling you and saying, hey, just to let you know, your one property is a meth lab. It's happened to me. These are not fun phone calls to get from management companies. Let's look at Airbnb. What are you going to do with this? Isn't this tough? I don't know how you guys do this. You're like, well, Bravo said Airbnb is going in the toilet. Nick said Airbnb is going in the toilet. I'm just, okay, so there's your fundamentals. There's what's happening. There's your macro. Let's look at the charts. Are you guys buying or selling? And the answer is, I need more indicators. I mean, I could clearly see that there was a bottom over there. Sorry, I've had this. It's like, oh, that's a bottom. Okay, looks like we're hitting the top. I'll draw it for you. See, blue line, see, look, kind of like a channel, but it's not, because I got a lot more to show you. I mean, yes, it is a channel. Let me turn on just one thing for you. This is what are we in a bull market or are we in a bear market? Oh my goody, drum drop. What? I have not been drinking. It's just Celsius. That's it. A little bit of energy in the morning. We're in an uptrend, my friends. So this would not be a company you short. You short under. You swing trade above. My hand can't go there. But now let me turn on my new Bravo indicator. Sick, look at that. Also, it takes the, if you want bright colors and things like that, you're able to turn it on and off. Link in the description for all of my indicators. And I will turn on three for you. This is the first one to go, okay, where are we at? Looking at, and I'll have to explain it. Bravo band, that's the purple and blue. You go into that, you're gonna get rejected. These little pluses that show up, that's your nine count. After that, it gets rejected, look. I mean, come on, right there, bingo, bam, bingo, bango, right here, boom, bam. And how much, what percentage? Wow, that's pretty good, Bravo. How do you know highs and lows? You would have lost 24% on that. You understand? And also, you need confluence. You need all of it to go, okay. Don't you just go off of one indicator. Look at this, Bravo band, boom, gets rejected. What are you down on that one? This from the top. Oh, Airbnb is going to the moon. Let's ride this thing. You just lost another 25%. What did you bounce on? Eh? That's the 200. Now this last trade, it is a sick, well actually, the one right before that. See? Boop, right in his band. Golly, that guy is smart. We come down, bounce on the 200. What's gonna happen? You see this right here? I'll zoom in for you. And here we are, zoomed in. Boom, hit it, come down. Off the 200, find support. There is the Bravo 9. You see how the bands twist? So pretty, look at that. Just for you, for confirmation. But you would be right there. It's that candle. That is where you jump in. I will, I'll circle it for you, just in case you cannot see it. That one. Full candle close above the pretty little Bravo 9. Above the 200, don't get religious about your trades. Be very close. From here, I'm gonna measure from the middle all the way up. You hit a nine count right there. It's 16%. You're taking profit, my friend. Oh, and just in case you wanna turn on some more things, that was just, that's a swing trade. Boom, let's do this. Turn on one more indicator and uno mas for you. This is actually the reactor, bounced off the reactor. In green, you're good to go. Very new, very important line. Your green line, your red line. Green line, good. Red line, not good. You go red, you go dead. You trade bear market. Also, if you would like to know how to do this, don't just think you can go, okay, I'll just grab the indicators and we're gonna be good to go. No, you need to know how to trade first. So please, because you put me over 200,000, thank you. All of my courses for 200. And if for some reason it says 199, I'm under-promising, over-performing. I don't know what I do. That word just too weird for me. One of the other indicators that which came on, I actually gave you a price target of right here. This was looks like a falling. Well, actually, it tells you. It's a falling wedge right here. See that? Falling wedge. When you break this right here, you ride it all the way up. And also, your little Bravo band here flipped. Look. Oh, and falling wedge. Oh, look at all of this confluence. And your price target, it told you your price target was right there at 120. So you would have went from in the 90s to 120, bingo bango, right on target. But I would have been taking profit right in there, right there, which that's fine. So ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, even though me, the news, which that sounds pathetic even saying it, does not mean Airbnb, the stock, I'm going to go short it. You're up, you're above the 200. So again, look, here's your news. Here's the stock market. Don't intertwine them, but I'm telling you, it is bad out there. This is the whole student loan debt, credit cards. The restart of student loan payments is going to pressure the U.S. consumer. It's going to pressure you quite a bit, especially when you're saying 34% of borrowers saying they'll be unable to make any payments, none. So that's a third, right? If I'm doing the math properly, slightly a little bit more. As a doom and gloomer, it's over half. I mean, just think about that for a second. Everyone is strapped. But I mean, the rich aren't. They always seem to do well. Well, that is why I come to this channel and say, hey, why don't you be rich and start businesses and sell products and trade equities, even in a recession? The young kids, the younglings, they're like, what's going on? Credit card holders under the age of 25 have seen the largest increase in credit card debt over the past year. They keep going. Charge, with the average credit card balance for that age group rising 1,376, up 16% from 1,182. Good luck paying it off there, little boy. But anyways, you guys, thanks for hanging out with us, having a good time. Hopefully we can do that in life and on this channel. I love you. Thank you for coming every day. If you do, or if you maybe miss a day, if your phone rings and it's me, I'm just reminding you, you missed yesterday. Also, if you're new, if you want to subscribe, the button's right down there. Maybe hit the like. Maybe put some things in your brain with the discount of what, $200? That thing's going away. And I'm telling you, once my subscriber count goes to 201, one, and it's really close. So I'm just warning you. If you wanted it at the lowest price ever, grab it. It's a thank you gift, and I will see you tomorrow.